only publisher in the room. By the way, Fred Waugh, I wanted to, I forgot to mention him briefly, earlier. Fred Waugh published his very first book, is that correct, The Gathering?
That's correct.
You're not actually up yet, hang on. Relax.
Oh, I'm not going.
Not quite. David B. next. He's going to, well, David B., why don't you come up and say what you're going to say?
Well, I'm Chris B. So I'm Chris Bromige, I'm David's son, and I am here, will be reading, and I'm very gratified to see as many people here as are here, and some of my former and current students are in the back, and my daughter and my son are here. It's fantastic. I just thought that my, and my wife, and yes, and my mom, and yeah, it was all kinds of people. And my daughter's friends, and my friend Sandra, and yes, there's lots of people here. But I'm actually just here to introduce this little segment of a reading that I discovered footage for online about last week sometime. And there is a there's an interesting kind of documentary made by James Garahan, who took this picture of Dad. He took about, I don't know, 100 hours of footage and brought it down to about an hour long. But it's really Dad after he'd had several strokes. So you can find that online. That was shown at the Sebastopol event I went down to in California. And it's a beautiful thing, but if you don't, if you didn't know my dad, if you weren't around to see him at that stage of his life is not the David that I remember and that many of you remember. So this is Dad, strangely enough, October 22nd, 1994, that would be his birthday, his 59th birthday back in 1994, down in Los Angeles. And so I chose this little clip because the Sebastopol event, Bob was there, was kind of serious, and there wasn't much laughter, and I didn't quite get it because every reading I've been to of my dad's was full of hilarity with George screaming stuff from the back and Peter making cheap shots. So anyway,
I'm sorry if some of these poems are funny. I certainly don't mean them to be jokes. But it's true that I deal in cognitive dissonance, and that makes people laugh. There's nothing we can do about it.
He's not sorry.
But master of dialects, which originally was master of dialects, and I thought, oh, no, I'm a small-time mimic. Masher seemed much more to the point, especially thinking of the world today and how all languages are getting mixed up. Let's see, are you? Touch can't do tone without some crutch, and any class of person can break bone, requiring time off work, a state of sin, says the boss who's a jerk. Between the assignment and the invention, the terminal and the laptop, the new enslavement will find its laudators with its moiety. Otherwise, poetry will be written. Acts of defiance, assertions are never naked. That some individual stole time from Leviathan to pile Pelion on Ossa. Senseless, worse, self-destructive. Nerve endings, hungry for blood, rage, and won't shut up. Listen to reason. Smarten up. Piss or get off. Sov keeper. Here's a kiss.
Who's next?